For so long, the moon was nothing but a mystery to humanity. Until we were able to set foot on the lunar surface in 1969, the idea of living beyond our earthly home seemed impossible. But through years of discovery, innovation, and the insatiable desire to dream bigger and go further, NASA is working to make this once impossible idea a reality.
Under NASA's Artemis program, the agency is eager to learn all that it can about the presence of water on the moon in advance of sending the first woman and next man to the lunar surface and establishing a sustainable human presence there by the end of the decade.
NASA has identified several technology gaps related to harvesting and moving large quantities of resources on the moon, including hardware capable of operating in extreme cold and permanent to near-permanent darkness. Robotic systems for excavation will need to withstand the harsh environments inside permanently shadowed regions at the lunar south pole, where ice has been observed and the targeted landing site for crewed Artemis missions.
Centennial Challenges, a competition initiative under the Prizes, Challenges, and Crowdsourcing Program within NASA's Space Technology Mission Directorate, is able to directly support the agency's missions by offering solutions to its biggest technology gaps, all by using the tremendous power of citizen innovators. The Break the Ice Lunar Challenge is designed to develop new technologies that will support this mission and make life on the moon possible.
This is a great opportunity to hopefully contribute to NASA's goals of ice extraction on the moon and to work with the students and professors that are part of the Colorado School of Mines Space Resources Program. NASA gave us a great goalpost to shoot for, and working with Lunar Outposts was an awesome experience for me to learn and grow my career as an engineer.
We received several innovative lunar excavation and transportation technologies developed by teams that competed in Break the Ice Lunar Challenge. We'll be pushing some of these excavation technologies further by testing them in a large thermal vacuum chamber like the one you see here. These chambers are capable of simulating lunar environmental conditions, especially the permanently shadowed regions, hard vacuum, and very low temperatures.
Contributing to NASA's mission is an honor because we get to be a part of a global collective that strives toward a common goal.
Necessity is the mother of invention, and living in space will lead to huge innovation that will make humanity more prosperous.
Our university has participated in several Centennial Challenge competitions over the years, and we're always so impressed with how much we grow and learn from participating. We're honored that NASA would be willing to consider our inputs as potential solutions for real-world space travel.
Hi, my name is Denise Morris. I'm the NASA Centennial Challenges Program Manager. I am so very proud of the teams we have competing in our NASA Break the Ice Lunar Challenge. If the teams move forward to compete in level 3 of the challenge, they will go to a head-to-head competition to test their prototypes at a NASA-designated facility. We have $1 million up for grabs for level 2 and up to $1.5 million for level 3. Congratulations to all the teams for making it this far, and I wish you the best of luck in level 3.